Lieutenant General Todd Semonite, 54th Chief of Engineers, and we're on the road again. Today we're in Puerto Rico at the Guajataca Dam, and this is a critical issue that's down here with some of the challenges with Irma and Maria. With me is Colonel Jim DeLapp. He's the commander here in Puerto Rico to be able to do a lot of different missions: roofing, temporary power, blue roofs, navigation. But one of the biggest single challenges we have, Jim, is this particular dam. Tell our team a little bit about what do we have here and how did this all evolve?
Yes, sir. Well, we're here and on behalf of FEMA, who asked us, and the Puerto Rican government for technical assistance. So the Army Corps of Engineers was asked to provide technical assistance here on the damages to the Guajataca Dam following the storm of Hurricane Maria. So we're here, right when we hit the ground, we brought out our engineers. Dennis Aveni's here from Jacksonville District and many others that came in from Jacksonville and around the Corps to take a look at the dam and provide that technical expertise. We've come up with a solution to make a temporary or emergency fix to stabilize the spillway that was severely damaged during the storm. So that's what you see going on behind us.
So Jim, just set it up a little bit. This is the spillway that came right in the face of the dam. So if in fact we don't do something here, what's at risk? What could go wrong?
Yes, sir. Well, as you can see, the spillway, the entire lower half of the spillway was washed away because of the massive amount of water that came through. And progressively, sections of the spillway have continued to erode and drop. So what we're trying to do is shore this up so that additional pieces of the spillway don't continue to fall.
Yeah, because at some point, if you don't, you obviously have a danger of cutting back into the dam. And then imagine a lot of people downstream if we can't get this thing under control.
Exactly, yes,
so,
sir.
So Dennis, the Colonel kind of set it up. What's the kind of the short-term solution here, and then what's kind of the long-term?
Well, short-term solution, sir, is the jersey barriers that have already been placed.
There's a lot of concrete. How many did those that we put in?
502.
Wow.
Basically, that's to buttress up the bottom of the failed zone. Right now, we're using the Chinook choppers to bring in sandbags to build a check dam at the downstream. When that's in place, we'll be able to open up the 54-inch pipe, get more water off the dam. Once that's done and stabilized, then we can start looking to future repairs like grouting the underslab, anchoring the slab, moving forward with future design work, i.e. changing the spillway type, rebuilding this portion of the dam that's failed.
So right now we're flying pumps in out of the United States. We're going to make basically a couple of big pumps with a bunch of siphons, right? Just walk through real quick. How does that work?
Essentially what's going to happen on the left side of the dam, they're going to establish first pumps, and then once the pumps are in place, they'll get those running. We'll feed water to this canal up here to get water to the people in the northwest portion of the island. And additionally, we'll have another six siphons dumping down into the river to get water away from the dam. At that point, we'll end up dropping the water in the reservoir about 20 feet. So we'll be able to take a 100-year storm. At that point, we'll be able to proceed with the long-term repairs.
So this really, Jim, you talked about, you know, Mobile's in here helping out. Normally, Jacksonville does most of the work, but this is such a big mission that your district came in to help out. The short-term fix, FEMA does response. So we're responding right now to get this back into a safety zone. If we have a lot more storms, and I know there's been a lot of rain here, then you have the risk of this thing continuing to fill up and having more and more water come over. So that's why it's critical to bring it down 20 feet or so. But then there's this whole other mission that we're gonna end up having to have probably congressional help with to be able to rebuild this spillway and get it going. And that's probably a 2 or 3 year mission, isn't it, Dennis?
Roger that, sir.
All right, well, I tell you what, we're the experts in dam safety. We have 715 dams all around the United States. And as much as we're talking about a lot of technical stuff, I think what's most important is to the people of Puerto Rico. We have real people living right down from this dam, and they've got to be able to make sure that they can go to sleep at night knowing that somebody's here to watch and protect this dam. And I'm real glad that the Jacksonville District and the expertise you guys bring in then, under the leadership of Mobile, Jim, and everything that you've got here, it's a real team working side by side. We are not out of the woods on this one. We've got to be able to get this thing stabilized, stop water coming off that spillway, and then bring that down, bring down the whole lake, and then the bottom line is go ahead and start planning on rebuilding it.
Yes,
so for both of you guys, I'm real proud of everything we've done. We're way up on the northwest corner of Puerto Rico, but it's all about our civilians, our leadership out here on the ground, making a difference in Puerto Rico. Dennis, great job. Thanks for being here. Jim, thanks for everything you guys have done. So from Puerto Rico, continue to do a lot of hard work for Maria. I can't be more proud of you guys.